Hey, good evening guys, can you all hear me? So here is the link for the today's quiz and the code 19344. So all of you have to put your name and your school name for identification. Okay, so yes, now quickly sign up. Quickly sign up. So let me see how many of you are there. So you have the book copy with you. You have the book copy with you. So we have 36 people so far. Okay, so. So you have to protocol is this? So you're allowed to see the book, no problem. You're allowed to see the book. Okay, so we'll wait for others also to join in. Yes, you need to put your name up like that so that, you know, I can identify all of you. I can write so school name and school name. Okay, so the idea is today's session is also for making you learn how to learn. Mentee code is given 19344. Okay, so all of you quickly join. Quickly join, join, join. So, you know, the quiz has to be joined by all. So right now 41 people are there. Vijan is counting 52. I don't know. So yes, all of you must quickly join in. Yeah, come on, quickly. So here, the idea is to also learn how to learn these subjects. No, nothing, no problem, Jagrav. Let it be. Let it be. A few people are in unmute mode.
What the heck? That is so creepy. I'm weird.
Yeah, all of you can hear me. Hello. Yeah. So I was saying, you know, the way the questions have been designed is going to give you an indication how to study these subjects as well. And that's how we will be, you know, if this really is accepted by all, then we'll conduct more number of quizzes, more frequency, more number of questions. Okay, so that's what is the idea. Yes, it will be fastest finger first. So let me see. So you had been given the opportunity to go through the questions, or sorry, go through the text. Everything will be there. Everything will be there in the book itself. But question need not be, you know, directly from the book. So that is for you to explore beyond what is given in the book. Okay. So hence, please understand what I'm trying to say. I hope you understood the philosophy. The philosophy is for you to explore beyond the book, right? So the questions will be such. So how it is going to proceed is something like this. You see the question, then try to find the answer out in the book, or you can search it on the net. And when you get the answer, you can mark it. Okay. And the question need not be, or the fact or the answer need not be there on the book also, but it will be linked to the book. So hence, okay, hold on guys, there are a few people who are still struggling to join in. Okay, so I think it's time now, shall we start? So I can see 61 62 people. No, you don't need to write anything. All are MCQs, so only one option correct. So that is what I am giving you, clarity in the first place. So only one option correct, but it did not, all of them are factual. A few might be application based. So hence, apply your knowledge and find the fact out, and then mark your answer. So shall we proceed? So give me a thumbs up if everyone is okay. Then we can start. Okay. Okay, guys. So here is today's first geography quiz to make you a little bit more prepared with the curriculum of grade 9 geography. So here we start. So the quiz is now started, and you can see the code. And the first question is on the board. So which of the following came on the earth first? So there will be real speed, you know, so only 30 seconds will be given for any question. And this question is very, it is easy, but I have purposefully given this question so that, you know, when we study social science, do not forget that everything starts with humans and ends with humans only. If we are, you know, for all this knowledge acquisition and all. So religion, nation, civilization, all later. First humans. Okay. Not sure of this one, never mind. So still people have got, so civilization came before humans also, and nation also, and religion also came before humans. That is surprising. So hence, this is to, you know, make the concept clear to one and all that none of religion, nation, civilization were there before humans. So hence, okay, so it will be like that. So hence, yeah, so hence this particular question was purposefully given so that all of you are aligned towards the right knowledge. Okay, so let's go. No problem. Okay. So here is, many people would have misclicked also, so don't really be harsh on them. So here is the first leaderboard. Let me see who clicked it first. Okay, so Raghav was the first person who to view, and 954 is really awesome, but only 7 points behind is Harita. That's really cool. Okay, so HSR, INR, YPR, INR, YPR, INR, INR, HSR. Tony, yours is HSR, right? Okay, so no scene of KRM. KRM guys, where are you? Come on. Next question is for you. Here is the next question. Okay, Krish, all the best. Which of the following is not among the ancient civilization of the world before we study India? Oh my God, this is super fast. Okay, so before we study about India, we must know about some facts. Something must be clear before. Okay, so still people have to be, you know. Oh, I was not expecting that all of you would be knowing all that. By the way, which one is the oldest one? Can anyone say in the chat? Egyptian, Indus, Mesopotamian, British. Which is the oldest one? Meso? C? Meso? Okay, wow, amazing. So one person, Egyptian, also Indus, British. Okay, very good. Very Indus, supposedly, because now we have to still prove it. We have got some evidences, but we have not been able to decipher the language, the script. So hence, but it is assumed to be, you know, yes. It is assumed to be the oldest one, more than 5,000 years ago and beyond, before that also. Anyway, so this is still to be established without any doubt. Okay. No. Indus and Meso are not same. What are you talking about? Yeah. Raghav bhai, thoda geography also, right? And history. Never mind. Okay. Leaderboard. Here is the leaderboard. Here. So, okay. Who was the fastest? Wow. You are better in geography than maths, I believe. Okay, cool. Okay. So, Raghav was, you know, asking a wrong question. So, you know, no problem. Very good. So, HSR is now there. YPR. But still, I don't see any sign of KRM. Where are these people? Are they not playing KRM, guys? Krish, oh my God, just coming. Okay, let me see. Chalo, let me see. Next is, are you ready for the next one? Next one, ready? Here is the next question. So the next question, Indian economy is primarily. So these are all warm-up questions. I hope you're able to answer it quickly. So this is done. Okay, great. Okay, so what is it? What do you think, guys? Now that 71 people have already marked it. Okay, You got it wrong. No problem. Here is the final answer. So Indian economy is still primarily agriculture based. So lots of people are there, and primarily the word was primarily, right? So obviously industry is much behind than agriculture in India. Services are they're catching up, but then in terms of people involved, and that was the sense of it. So agriculture is still taking care of the entire, most of the population. Anyways, so here is, so you got a little confused, I believe. Never mind. Okay. So here is the new leaderboard. Okay. So close fight. I see KRM now. That's so nice. Oh, lots of people are there. Great. So HSR. Oh, where are only one INR. Okay. Kaveri. Kaveri is from which school? I got confused. So which school? So you should have mentioned your school for making it more fun. So one R&R is also there. That's so nice. Nice. Very good. So let's move on. How many questions done, by the way? This is the next question here. In terms of size of its territory, India ranks in the world. This is like piece of cake. So you have been, okay, Raghav is like super fast now. Very good. So you know this is mentioned in the in the text here. So Seko, what I have done is I've taken this and I have just used, I'll not show you where is that. So you can see later on it comes. So it will be, you know, where is that? Anyways, you know, I have picked it from somewhere in this file only. Ooh, wait, what did I do? Grab back, what do I do? Oh, thanks. Okay, so all of you have anyways activate it. Okay, so where did it go? You are done. So let me just click on. Oh, this is the next question or something? No, leaderboard. Yes. So this is a needle leaderboard. Okay, so Raghav still leads the pack. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Nice to see all this fight. Very good. Krish, join again quick. Join again. Join again. You can just reload the site. If anyone gets kicked out, just join again, reload. Okay, let's move on. All done, Krish. Give me a thumbs up if you're okay. Oh, and ranks. Oh, I see. I thought, okay, never mind. Here is the next question. Easy one. Again, very much there in the book. No, not there in the book. Now, here is where research starts. Let me see how many of you can get it correct. This is where, so for example, if I came across this statement that India ranks 7th, then I would definitely go and see who are the top 10. Who are the top 10? So who's the first country, the biggest country, size-wise? Oh, let us not go to that. Yeah, definitely Russia, right? Okay, so very good. Let me see how many of you got it. Okay, so there's still people who say Australia. So Australia is bigger, guys. Australia is bigger than, yes. So US, Canada, China, Australia, Brazil, and one more. Which one? So US, Canada, Russia, Brazil, China, and one more is there. One more. Which one is there? Australia. Did I not say Australia? Yes, good. So India is 7th and Argentina is 8th. So you must know who are the, you know, nearest competitors of Argentina. USSR was supposed to be the largest landmass, but then in 1991 it got dissolved into, but still Russia is the, okay, very good. So this is information. Argentina comes 8th. Next. Yeah, yes, Milena, tell me.
Sir, I answered in 2 seconds, sir. My name didn't come on the leaderboard.
No, leader, if you are, or you, you know, cumulative, this is cumulative score, Sunena.
Oh.
So if you start from start only, you are in the top 10, you will see yourself there. Otherwise, you will improve. Okay, never mind.
Oh.
Keep quizzing. Keep quick, going and answering. Okay, next, folks. Here is the next question. So all set, here is the land area of Indian territory is total land. This is a factual question and it's a huge, huge landmass. Okay, so which one? 4.28 million square kilometer, my guess. 3.28 million square kilometer, 2.28 million and 1.28 million square kilometer. So this you must remember, right? How much is it? This information is also present in the book very, very specifically. Will end before 9. Okay, right? So, most of you have read it. So, very good. 3.28 million. Never forget this fact. This is a fact that Indian territorial landmass is 3.28 million square kilometers. Okay, so this is a factual question, guys. So, here is the leaderboard on this. That's cool. Very good. So still Raghav is leading the pack. Vihan comes. Oh, Srijan. Okay. So here is Karen in the second spot. Never mind. Good going, guys. All of you there. Pratham from NAFL is also there. So encouraging. Good. And my, you know, Pratham, hats off to you because you are from ICSE background and you are doing and playing CBSE quiz. That's really appreciated. Okay, appreciate it. Really, really good. Really good. Next is this question. Okay. Learn geography through questions is the funda. Which one of the following is correct? Now you have to be very patient and read through. Be very patient and read through. Don't read. This is application based. So you have to know something to. Indian latitudinal expanse is more than longitudinal expanse. Indian latitudinal expanse is less than longitudinal. The southernmost point of India is in southern hemisphere. And Tropic of Capricorn passes through India. Okay, and here is the answer. Now this statement, so many people have, now I understand. See, here is where this, you will always remember this. Now Indian latitudinal expanse is more than longitudinal expanse, guys. How do you calculate it? See, north-south expanse, latitudinal expanse means north-south expanse. So north-south is actually marginally more. So, you know, around 3000 something. So how do you, so if you see, north-south expanse, India. Let me, so when I'm studying this, I will always find this out. Okay. So if you see, see, north-south extent is bigger than east-west extent in India. No, latitude is not east to west, my dear. Latitude is north to south. That means basics. Latitude is always north to south. Right? So hence, if you see, see, India 3214 kilometer north to south and 2933 kilometer east to west. Always remember. Can you see this figures, guys? 3214 kilometer from Arunachal Pradesh to the westest, or westest is the wrong word, the last point of Gujarat. And here from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. Okay. Yes. Here. So hence, always remember this fact. Now you'll never forget that north-south expanse is. Yes, longitude gives east and west expanse. Latitude gives you right. What is that? North south thing. Okay. So now, so people have gone wrong here. So there must be some change in. What is Nitya? Nitya is saying something. No, sir. What is that, Saurav? Hold on. Let's discuss. What is that? You can unmute and say. Unmute and say. Yes, longitudinal expanse is east and west. Oh, Saurav, that's long. Wrong concept. Wrong concept. Longitude is east to west expanse. Latitude is north to south. Is that okay? So, is that okay? Is that
clear? Sure, but I searched like three sites and this is latitude lines run east and west.
East and west, that's fine. That's what. They run east and west, but they give you expanse from north to south. I think I need to explain this to you.
So
I understood. If two lines are parallel lines, the expanse is the distance between the line. No. See, maths in latitude, longitude also. Right? For if you want to measure the expanse, you have to measure the distance between two parallel lines. So definitely they run east to west or west to east. They are circles basically. So they are constant, you know, they are circles, coaxial circles. If you see mathematically, they all are circles. They are parallel to each other. But the distance between two parallel lines will give you the east-west or north-south expanse. Okay. Is it okay? Clear to everyone? So clear. Okay, keep, make your concepts clear, guys. So hence, that was application-based. So I hope everyone is clear. Anyone wants more explanation to this? Latitude gives you expanse. Which expanse? North to south. Longitude gives you expanse. Which expanse? East to west. Okay? Be clear. Latitude runs from east west in east west direction. Longitude runs in north south direction, from north pole to south pole. Okay? No problem. Yes, I will send. Don't worry. Next is this. Again, this will be a fact based question. Yes, now see, latitudinal expanse is which one? So these are fact-based, you must be very thorough with this. India lies in which hemisphere? That is very, very important. So if you know Indian expanse is from tropical to subtropical, moving towards temperate. I don't know if you know all these terms. So we are right now in subtropical or tropical zone. Do you know this? We are right now in tropical or temperate zone? Right, so we are in, okay, here also people have made, you could have used the book. Yeah, book is in front of you. Keep a copy on your mobile phone maybe. So this is the number, 8.4 degree north, 8 degree 4 minute north to 37 degree 6 minutes north. Yes, first phase, right? In fact, you would be astonished. I have made 25 questions from just one page. That's it. So in one page, 25 questions, and you are settled for life. You will never revise this page again in your life because you will be remembering all the data. 8 and 37, too accurate. Yes. Good. Good guess. Good guess, Monisha. So hence, anyone knows why it is degree? Where is this degree? Degree we study in maths. How come latitude also has degrees? How? Why is this degree? Why are we talking about degrees here? Any idea? 360 by 15, 24. Why? And what is this circle? So circle is degree. So what is this degree? When I say 8 degree, where degree is for an angle, isn't it? Degree is measure of what angle? Which angle are you measuring? So I don't know if you're aware. Let me tell you quickly so that you are concept-wise clear. I don't know if you're aware about this, that this is how it is. Wait, I will show you. So what is the degree? Please put your mic on mute. Sorry. Mic on mute.
So could
Yeah.
it be like if you take opposite long if you take opposite latitudes, then if you take opposite latitudes and take it as like a slice, it would be like a perfect circle, and then from the center you can make fractions or like parts.
Okay, good guess, but no, dear. I will explain why it is degree. See, this is our circle Earth, right?
So is
This.
it because it's easier, to use trigonometry to find out the measures of the distances?
No, so what I'm saying is why degree, which degree we are talking about? So when we say 8 degree north, 8 degree north is a latitude, isn't it? Is it a latitude? 8 degree latitude. Do you agree this is a latitude? Where is this angle being formed? This is the angle being formed. So 8 degree latitude is this circle. So it is a line right now, but then if you look at the sphere, the circle will appear like a line from the, if you watch like that. Okay, now this is the center of the earth. Now this point is 8 degree north. This is the angle 8 degree north. So hence equator will be 0 degree and pole is 90 degree. You get that? Do you get that? This is what you meant, Monisha. Anyways, if you meant that, so this is Arctic Circle. So this is 66 degree something minutes, right? This is Tropic of Cancer. So this one is Tropic of Cancer, let's say, PO Cancer. And this is what, 23 degrees approximately? Correct? So, right, so this is what the angle is, right? And same way for longitude, how many latitudes are there? So you have 90 in this side, 90 on that side. So there are 180 degrees, right? So from minus 90 to plus 90, 180 degrees. But for longitude, we have 360 degrees, right? So it's like, from north south, there is a Greenwich City in London, from which is considered to be the standard meridian. And from there, start going to different locations like that. So it is difficult to show you from this perspective, but assume that Greenwich and a line joining Greenwich to the center of the Earth and any other location. Okay, that is the angle which is talk we are talking about as longitude. So I hope this latitude is clear. So see, maths is everywhere, right? For angles, yes, correct. Next question.
What apostrophe is minutes, right?
Yes, 8 degree 4 minutes. So 1 degree is 60 minute. You will learn in geometry when we'll be dealing with geometry. 1 degree is 60 minutes and 1 minute is 60 seconds. In angles also it's like that of time. Okay, here is the leaderboard for this one. Okay, so Srijan was anxious because. Okay, that's nice. Pratham from Nepal, this is real stuff. I am loving it. Why? Because Pratham is answering those questions. Pratham, you've already done it in ICSE board, is it? Never mind. So it was anyways allowed to all of you to read through. So next question is here. Longitudinal, so latitude was, you now know. So let me not answer this right now here. Yeah. Nice one, Monisha, like that. Pratham is Pratham. Great. Cool. So this is also very clear to everyone. All the figures are same, only the east-west thingy I have purposefully. So India is in which hemisphere in that sense? Eastern or Western hemisphere? Oh, okay. So fact that means it shows that you guys are not very good at remembering facts. Here is where you have to, right? Remember the facts. Okay, remember the facts. So 68 degrees 7, 687. So I used to remember like that. 687, 97, 25. You know, and then obviously the first two digits are the degree. Okay, no problem. No, you have to see, you take two, three more times this quiz and you will be remembering for life. Okay, never mind. See, obviously this is not correct. So this is, I think most of you have misclicked it. Okay, so the answer remember 68, 7, 97, 25. 68 degree, 7 minutes, 97 degree, 90, what was that? 97 degrees, 25 minutes. Okay, folks, here is the next one. Oh, sorry, next question. So Krishna is there, very good. Up. This is good question. Yes, so which one? This, you know, so we are called tropical nation. Why? Because there is one line, imaginary line, which passes through India, and we are in North Hemisphere, all of us. So hence answer is very certainly Tropic of Cancer. That's really nice. Most of your prime meridian doesn't cross through India, my dear friends. Prime meridian goes through London, UK. Okay. Now London actually is a city called Greenwich. Okay, someone's mic is on mute, please. Okay, so equator is nowhere close to India. Neither is Capricorn. My rank, I'm not playing at all. Okay, very good. This looks nice. This looks nice. Okay. Catch up, catch up, catch up. Okay, next. So all your geography will be learnt through quiz. Don't worry. You don't need to go through books at all. This is, if you have the knowledge, then you will be able to answer it. You have to explore this. Go to the internet, search where, whose father or where is it? What is the capital of Lakshadweep? Too easy, okay. Yes. Very good. So my geography teacher, though, there was a time when, oh, still, okay, so there are people, so rightly, you know, confused also, no problem. We were taught to how to draw a map of India very quickly within 1 minute, right? So you have to 30 seconds. Yes, so hence we were you know, trained in drawing map of India also very quickly, 15, 20 seconds and then done. Great, yeah. Lakshadweep Islands are closer to Indian mainland than Andaman and Nicobar, because Andaman and Nicobar is, you know, if you see the map of India, so go to, there is a very good site called Maps of India, right? Map of India, right? So you can clearly see from the, so what Monisha was mentioning is, you know, here is the Andaman Nicobar, quite far, right? Quite far, near Thailand, and yeah, and this is Lakshadweep. And the capital is Kavarati. Can you see this here? Kavarati. Okay. So capital is Kavarati. So you must remember that. Okay, it's not. Never mind. So I'm saying leaderboard, please. Oh my God, Srijan, why are you so impatient? Okay, here is the leaderboard. Yeah, Burma is Myanmar. Very good. So here is the new leaderboard, and Srijan has okay. So now. Okay, no change in the leaderboard. So close. Okay. So you have to learn, Raghav, everywhere, you know, you have to, this is exploration, and through exploration you learn the maximum. You will never forget this question again in your life, that Indira Point, the southernmost point of India is. Okay. So, very good. So all of you have answered. So now I have not given you very, so these questions will not be, you know, obviously some stress has to be there on mind. So definitely it is, you know, very good. So definitely it is in Andaman and near Kanyakumari. It's located in Nicobar Islands, right? So Indira Point, where is the Indira Point? Actually the southernmost tip of India. So southernmost tip of India is Indira Point, or actually was, right now during 2004 or 5 tsunami came, right? Yes. How does it matter, right? It got submerged. That's still in India, right? So in 2004 the tsunami submerged it. So Indira Point was named after Mrs. Indira Gandhi in 1984. In 1984. These are facts you must know. Okay, Indira Gandhi was our prime minister, and she visited that point. There is a big lighthouse also there, which is very, very famous. And Nicobar is the southernmost island. So Andaman and Nicobar, the northern islands are called Andaman islands, and Nicobar islands are the southernmost point. Actually, Nicobar islands have all those tribes of India who have never seen civilization in their life. One is Jarawa tribe. So this was very much in news. I don't know if you have, heard of it. Yep. Jarawa. Have you heard of all these terms? So there are tribals, Jarawa, right? So all these people, inhabit these islands, and it is out of bound for any Indian citizen. So you can't go there without a requisite permit. So those who will crack civil services, become the administrator of that part, you will get the, and it's a very, very beautiful place. Very beautiful place, at least in pictures. So you can see only in through pictures. Okay, here is the next one. Oh, first the leaderboard. Okay, so new. Oh, Jagrav and Naisava. Jagrav has studied. Very good, Jagrav. Great. So still the leaderboard doesn't change much. Okay. Okay, next one. Indira Point was earlier known as. This is not in the book. So you have to search. Come on, internet, search. So this is not in the book. So that's what I was trying to emphasize on. So let's say you got to know about Indira Point. So first thing, when I used to study, that time though there was no Google, my dear friends. Now though there is Google. So go to Google, search Indira Point, and get some bit of information about it. Okay. So hence there you will be knowing that it is. Okay. So most of you have got, I don't know how to pronounce this name. So Pygmation or Pygmation or Pygmation, whatever. So, yes, correct. So, how do you pronounce it? Right? That's Pygmat. Anyways, right? Yes, whatever, right? So, hence, you now know. So, it's called Pygmation Point. Okay, great. Remember this forever. Okay, very good. That's how you build your knowledge. You go to search, find something more about it, write down in your notebook. Okay, not much of a change now happening. I don't know why. Never mind. Let's go to a Pygmalion point. Yes, Manisha, that's correct. Correct, correct, correct. Now I remember it's Pygmalion. Thanks for that input. Pygmalion. Very good. Next. This is very much there in the book. You should be ready to click it the moment you see it. Wow. Amazing, in 1 second. In 1 second. Oh my god. Oh my god. And this is an insight. So, you know, we have. Can you imagine the proportion of landmass we have and the proportion of population we have? We are second biggest country population wise in the world. So every, what, 16th people is an Indian, not 16th, 7th, 7th people. Yep. One by 7, right? Yes. So 2.4%. So lesser mass, or, you know, total percentage wise, we have very less landmass and we have a lot of people, right? That is something. Okay, so very good. Okay, Srijan Ghosh is trying hard to catch up, but still the leaderboard is okay. Krishna is leading. Okay, never mind. Great going, guys. Keep it up. Next. Here is the, yeah, this is also a direct question. Look at the book and mark it. Such a long boundary, my god. Land boundary of India. Such a long land boundary. Yep, great. Great, very good. 3, 2, 1, done. And the answer is B. Very good. So many people have, I think by, they got mis, you know, so I have purposefully given the wrong unit. It is not miles. 15,200 kilometers is the total land boundary. Land boundary only between two nations, right? Okay. Okay. Next. Leaderboard. Okay, just you know, let's say trivia. Who knows this? What is the boundary between India and Pakistan known as? What is the name of that line? Anyone? No, not LOC. Not LOC. LOC is not boundary. Radcliffe. Wonderful. Dhruv. Radcliffe. Very good. And what is the name of the India versus China boundary? What is the name? India.
Can I also answer?
Are Ankur sir, good morning.
Within 1 second or 2 seconds, they answer 50, 40 people. I am embarrassed. I am maintaining the rank of 5. Some mean I am 72, 73.
Very good. So these people are really good at geography and really nice to see that. Lots of people are right. You know, very good guys. So hence, Radcliffe line was, Radcliffe line is what India and Pakistan. Radcliffe was the person who actually drew this line. McMahon is from India and between India. Okay, next. So, Mr. Radcliffe drew this line on a map of India and Pakistan came into being. Next question. Coastline now. So, you can, you know, coastline. How long is Indian coastline? So, it stretches from Gujarat in the west to what? West Bengal in the east, yes, and Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep. Yes, rounded off, obviously. I can't give you precisely meters level. Okay. Okay, Jagrav, no problem. So there will be some error in measurement also, no? When you are measuring 7516 kilometer, Jagrav says the answer is 7516.6. So 400 meters is allowed, right? No? 400 meters, so while calculating only, you will make a mistake while measuring it. Yes? So, okay, very good. So, there is no explanation needed. This was given in the book. Okay. This is the new leaderboard. Okay, fantastic. Fantastic. Some shuffle, no, still not. Oh, very good. Jagrav is catching up. Yes, India and China. Correct, Sunaina, correct. McMahon line is between India and China. Okay. This question is not there in the book. You have to find it. And it is really, let me see the distribution of answers here. So when you're studying about land boundary, go to internet, go to Wikipedia and find out about India. There's a good article on land boundary between India and other neighboring countries, and lots of information is there. Oh, you knew it already? Okay. 3, 2, 1, and here. Wonderful. So obviously, oh, China. No, that's a wrong answer. It's Bangladesh. That's surprising, isn't it? So when I came to know about it, I was also surprised that how come Bangladesh is... No, sir, it's Pak. No, sir, not Pakistan. It's Bangladesh. Okay, so Bangla, actually, you don't know. There are lots of enclaves between India and Bangladesh. Okay, so, you know, not China. Yes, that was also surprising. So if you figure out why is this, you'll come to know. I don't know if you've heard of enclaves. Have you heard of enclaves that India and Bangladesh share a lot of enclaves? So there are few districts or places or villages in India which belong to Bangladesh and vice versa. Right? So it's Bangladesh has, so India has longest boundary with, and with which we have the smallest or the shortest boundary. Which is the country? Which is the country with which we have the shortest boundary? Any idea? Shortest boundary.
So is it Afghanistan?
Afghanistan. Very good. It's hardly 100 kilometers, 106 kilometers to be precise, is between India and Afghanistan. Now that it is falling in POK, Pakistani occupied Kashmir, but then it is very much part of India. So what? It's our land. Okay, anyways. Now, next is leaderboard. Okay, so Ahan is worried about the leaderboard. So here is the leaderboard. Okay, now shuffling is happening. Okay. Yes, okay, very good. Karun is now on top against after Krishna, Srijan, Jagrav, Janvi. Very good, guys. Next question. Next question. Come on. Yes, this is a good question. Which of the following states do not have a coast or international border? So when you study about land boundary, then you have to go beyond, right? So you have to explore more about land boundary and things like that. And then you will be, you know, so you should be very, very, you know, so don't only restrict to, hey, this much length, that much length, and that. Study more about it. Who found it? Where did it come from? How long is it? Which all states are nearby? Okay, so Haryana and Chhattisgarh, very, very, you know, these are landlocked, so to say. Everything is landlocked, but Haryana and Chandigarh, it is surrounded by other states. Yes. Right? Nagaland and Sikkim. No, Sikkim is China and Nepal and Bhutan. Three places. Sikkim is touching China on the north, Nepal in the west, and Bhutan in the east. Nagaland boundary is Myanmar's boundary. West Bengal is Nepal and China. Bangladesh is one. Jharkhand is also a landlocked, you know, or all states are around Jharkhand. So I belong to Jharkhand. So that's not the option because West Bengal was there. And Madhya Pradesh is also, you know, covered or let's say surrounded by all the states, but Meghalaya is not. Okay. Meghalaya is, you know, Meghalaya in the south, southern Meghalaya is Bangladesh. Okay. Here is next question in the leaderboard. Yes, dear, I know MS Dhoni. He's my school senior. I have seen him playing also, so don't worry. So here is the leaderboard. Okay, sorry. Next. Okay, Indian landmass is called a peninsula because this is... Oh, within no time, everyone has done. Yeah, this is very easy. This is the first few lessons in geography they teach in the very first few sessions, isn't it? 1.6. Oh, people are okay. That's nice. 68 people have already voted, and 3, 2, 1. Cool. Oh my God, this is record. Amazing, folks. No one has even misclicked this. Okay, this is record in Centum Academy's entire quizzing history that everyone has got it right. Ankur sir, if you're there, you can see that. Everyone has marked it correct. That's real, real cool. Amazing, guys. You all rock. Keep it, keep the spirit high, guys. Pizza, done, done. Pizza party. Pizza party. Treats. Assured. Party. Okay. Very good. Next one. Pizza party assured. Wherever we'll meet, we'll have a pizza party. Okay. Next. Oh, so this is the leaderboard and the next question. Very good, very good. Really proud of all of you. Nice. This is research-based question. So whenever a big water body surrounded by land. What? Really? Are you able to see, guys? No, people are. But then your this thing would be working, right? Your, I think. Is this screen visible to everyone? I can see that.
Visible.
Yes. Oh, here people are confused. Okay. Okay. So three sides means delta was the, I think, thought process. But no, delta is a place where it's a piece of land actually. It's in triangle shape and hence called delta. Right. So delta is a triangle. So delta is a Greek letter. If you see, when you write something is a triangle ABC, that is called delta sign. Now delta is the piece of land where, or the portion where river meets the sea. So what, you know, as it's delta V, you know. So this is the explanation.
As we use, like in physics, we use na delta change.
Correct.
So x by delta t velocity.
Yes. So I will explain. This is a science question actually. So geography, physical geography is actually science only. Okay, so I will show you. Just a minute. Gulf is not right, bay is right. Bay, Gulf was not there, I think. Was there any choice like Gulf? I didn't give you Gulf. I give you strait, delta, estuary, and bay. Correct? So what is it? So whenever river meets, let's say this is your India, okay, and you know, river is coming like that, and it is a plain area. So what happens is, you know, there is no, there's no incline as such. So hence, water tends to flow out like that. Okay, so it's the gradient is very low. The gradient is so low that water just starts flowing all around. So this shape is a delta shape, and hence this is called a delta, right? The right answer is bay. Why? Because if you see, this is the Asian, right? So let's say India wise, this is India, isn't it? So this is India. Here is Bangladesh. Here is West Bengal. And this is bay. Why bay? Because from three sides it is locked with land. So this is Myanmar. Myanmar is this side. This is, let's say, Andhra Pradesh. This is Bangladesh above. So hence the water body, part of an ocean which is locked by land on three sides, is called bay. A strait is when there is a natural water body between two land masses. For example, you would have seen, yes, Bay of Bengal. So Strait of Gibraltar, right? Strait is where, or Park Strait, between Sri Lanka and, if you see, this is India like that, and here is Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is something like that. Oh, sorry. So this is called Park Strait. Park Strait. So between two landmass, there is water, right? Park Strait. This is strait. Okay, strait. And estuary is nothing but the water, the place where the river, you know, river meets the ocean. That's called estuary. Which one? Gulf is bigger form of a bay. No, Gulf is, okay. Gulf is similar to bay, but Gulf is something like that. It is also surrounded, but very narrow opening to Gulf. This is Gulf. So for example, if you see Gujarat, this is Gujarat, something like that, right? Something like that. And here is India, like that. Oh, sorry, the screen is not shared. Yeah, this is Gujarat, right? And this is, let's say, Bombay here, right? So this part, this, if you see, very narrow portion of water is there. This is Gulf. This is Gulf. Right? Gulf of Cumbert, Gulf of Kutch. This is called Gulf of Kutch. Yes. Right? So Gulf. So or Persian Gulf, where there is very narrow opening to the water body. Yes, yes, silence, please. So let's say this is land. This is land. This is land. And this is water. And very narrow opening to water body, that will be called Gulf. If it is wide opening, it is called. Now, run of Kutch is the land mass, guys, if you are getting confused. This is run of Kutch here. Run of Kutch is here. This one is run of Kutch. But this is Gulf of Kutch. Okay? Yes, yes, correct. That's estuary, right? So it's mouth of water river where tides are seen very, you know, prominently. Okay, so here is in a leaderboard. Right. So okay, most of you have got it. Now you'll understand. So when you see Bay of Bengal is in the east, don't stop there. Go and find out what on earth bay means. Okay, very good. Next one. This one is good question. If sun rises at 4 a.m. IST in Arunachal Pradesh, it will rise in Gujarat at. IST is Indian Standard Time. So Ahan has already prepared well, I think. So those who would have prepared well, they should ace it. Very good. So you must know there is some time gap between eastern and the western part of India. Okay, so great. So most of you, because there is 2 hours of lag between the eastern and the westernmost point of India, and this is because Earth is round and it takes some time. So if you noticed, if you remember, we had around 3,000 kilometers span between east and the western part of India. Okay, so there was an idea to divide India into multiple time zones, like US. US has 5 time zones. So every state has a different, you know, timing there. But India was also, you know, there was a proposal to divide India into 5, you know, more time zones. Yes. So time zones help in energy saving to a large extent. And also what happens is, but then we could not do it because our, you know, systems are not that robust. The literacy rate is not that high. Trains run not uniform timing. Just imagine if people just get confused between train timings here and there from Arunachal Pradesh to Gujarat and becomes chaotic. Okay. Yes. So this is, yes, very good. So next is leaderboard. That's nice. That's nice. Okay, so now, okay. So I see a lot of shuffling happening. Next guys. 20. Okay, next question. Chalo. I hope you are learning something today. So the idea was to make you standard meridian of India is Indian Standard Time is, or obviously it is marked with standard meridian. It is exactly at the midpoint of east and western part. So this is very much easier question, very easy question. You could just, you know, by common sense, you can figure it out. By common sense. Common sense. Yeah. So answer was A, right? Okay. Most of you have done it correctly. There could, you see, meridian cannot be north. Meridian is a longitude, so it has to be east and west. All the values were same, 82 degree, 30 minute. Okay. So if you see, west, south and north doesn't make sense. West cannot be because we are in eastern hemisphere. So, never mind. Here is the leaderboard. Okay, so not much of a reshuffling is happening actually. Never mind. So, people are maintaining their lead and Krishna is on top of his answers. Very good, Krishna. Keep it up. Next.
So, the screen sharing is not working.
Oh, is it? So anyway, you are able to see the question at your end, right? So let me reshare. I am able to see it actually.
It's repeatedly coming, screen sharing stops, screen sharing started.
Oh, then maybe, I don't know, from, can you just re-log in from for Mockstra? Just do not log out from the quiz.
Yeah.
Okay, so this was directly lifted up from the book. So Mirzapur, very good. Where is Mirzapur? Mirzapur is in UP and it passes through not only Mirzapur, it passes through. So your assignment should be whether, for example, in my civil services exam, the question was whether it passes through Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and other states. That is good. So you have to figure out which all, not Calcutta, obviously, in UP, UP. Uttar Pradesh, Mirzapur is in, yes, near Allahabad. That's correct. Right. So the question was standard meridian of India passes through Mirzapur. It doesn't only pass through Mirzapur. There are other places as well, but then that's all. So it exactly is in the middle midpoint of eastern and western points of India. Hence 82 degree 30 minutes. Okay. And hence, because of this reason, we are 5 hours and 30 minutes before the Greenwich Mean Time, right? So we are 5 hours 30 minutes ahead. Sorry, 5 hours 30 minutes ahead. Okay. So, and it is usually taken in the multiples of 30 minutes. No, this is the previous question. Oh, previous question.
So the same problem is occurring again.
Oh, who is this?
So it's Pratik.
No problem, Pratik. Just figure. You know, just keep playing with the quiz.
Even the chat is not working.
No, don't need. You just play quiz. Quiz is there, right? Okay. It is coming up. The questions are there. Don't worry. I will tell you the final result. So this is the leaderboard after 23rd question. Krishna, Vihan, Srijan, Jagrav, Karun, Ishika, Raghav, Vignesh, Abhishek and Parth. Very good. Two people from NAFL also are. Okay, so next question is. Which of the following statement is correct? Pay attention and then mark. Don't jump on to the conclusion. This is again directly lifted from your book. Duration of day is same as that of night across India. Difference of duration of day and night is same across India. India's latitudinal extent influences the duration of day and night. And there is no impact of latitudinal extent on duration of day and night. Okay, so very good. So the answer is 43rd one, C, and most of you have got it correct. Duration of day and night is directly related to the latitude and longitude. Why? You know, there is a movement of relative movement of sun. So you must be studying physics, may motion may relative motion. So there is relative motion between earth and sun throughout the year. So hence there is, you know, the impact of. So during the winter season, nights is longer in northern part of the country. Nights are longer in the northern part of the country in winter season. Okay, so everyone is bothered about the leaderboard, and here comes the leaderboard, and yes. And the final answer, Vihan is now on first place, YPR, great Vihan, nice to see that. Next one is, and the final one, guys, this is the last question of the evening, okay? Try and mark it. Okay, which of the following pairs of cities has the least difference between the duration of day and night? Application based. Let me see how many of you can crack it. So this must be, you know, this is also linked to your general knowledge. You must be aware of your latitudinal extent. Where is Bangalore vis-a-vis? Where is Chennai? Where is Hyderabad? Where is Delhi? Easy. Okay, most of you have answered. Okay. Here is the answer. Bangalore and Chennai. That's nice. Why? Because Bangalore and Chennai are the same latitude. Bangalore and Chennai are on the same latitude. If you see the map of India, right? What happened, Monisha? What happened? Monisha, say, what happened? Why are you saying no? What is you got it wrong, hence, or the explanation is wrong? I could not Leaderboard. Okay, here is the final leaderboard, folks. Oh my god. Oh, Srijan. And Vihan takes the lead. Okay, congratulations to Vihan. Right, very, very close. Very good, Vihan. Very good. Keep it up. That's so cool. Very good. Very good. Very good. So Srijan is second. Krishna comes third. Jagrav comes fourth. Vignesh then fifth. Ishika is sixth. Gandhar is seventh. Harita is eighth. Krish is ninth. And Abhishek is tenth. Very good, guys. I really, really, I hope this was useful to all of you. So how did you find the quiz? Was it okay? Do you want these kind of quizzes more? Right? How was it? Do you think it can be, you know, repeated multiple number of times so that your knowledge also increases, you learn also, and then you are preparing, or let's say your portions are also getting. Right? Very good. Right? So we'll have more. So, you know, now you have the book with you. Yes, we will do. So we will complete the geography quiz. So hence, every day actually, okay? Okay, okay, okay. Very good. Very good. History next. How many for history next? Or we shall finish this first and then go to history. So history will be also like that. Question answer based. You have to dig deep, find the question, answer, and then, you know. So great. Thanks a lot, guys, for, you know, coming and spending time over here. I hope this session was helpful to all of you. So three cheers to all of you. You got one question. So correct. All of you got it correct. So there is a pizza party for everyone. Okay, so hence, okay, bye-bye guys, good night, take care, and stay safe, see you on Monday again, bye-bye, good night.
Wow. Oh.